every time she does something, it's just so stupid and so ridiculous.
Yes.
Just the things that I want to do in real life that I can't.
Yes.
You know, when you just want something up, but you can't, you have to just, so I get to let it all out through her. So anytime she gets a release, I'm grateful. Everybody, I'm Tyler Perry.
And I'm Kelly Rowland. We just worked together on our new film, Mea Culpa, on Netflix. So we got to know each other very well.
Let's talk about what we don't know about each other.
Okay, well, this is between two faves.
Two faves. Kelly, so what do you think was the most challenging to juggle while you're shooting scenes, producing, and acting and making sure everything's... What do you think was the most challenging?
Being in the role and being in the scene.
Yeah.
And then on certain moments, just wondering what was happening behind the camera, just being nosy. You know
what I mean? That's also the producer who wants to know what's going on.
Of course. Yeah. Like, if I'm feeling it and it feels good, I want to know what it looks like at the same time.
Yeah, I know. And I wouldn't let you see it.
I know.
That's
yes.
why you're so great at it.
Yes. Well, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. I had a great director and you made me. Okay, it's my turn. Which Virgo quality do you most admire about yourself? And which are you working on the most?
First of all, Virgos are perfect, so I love everything about being Virgo.
Okay.
Yeah, no. I honestly, the thing that I'm working on is, and I continue to work on, is letting go of some of the things, because we can be perfectionists. We see everything. We notice everything. And I've always had to work within budgets. So it's like I've always wondered, what if I had an unlimited budget and an unlimited amount of time, what I could create, right?
Yeah.
So I had to figure out how to bring my A game into what I had. Mm. And that's why I think Mea Culpa turned out to be what it is. And the new movie, 6888, is because I'm able to bring that in. But those Virgo eyes, man, they don't let you rest. I think about all the hits you've given us, and I want you to rank these. Which one, two, and three, which are these songs you rank them, okay?
Oh boy.
All right. When Love Takes Over,
mm-hmm.
Commander,
mm-hmm.
and Motivation. One, two, three.
Ooh, yeah.
It's complicated.
Always
is.
I'll say Motivation, When Love Takes Over, Commander.
That's one, two, three.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
My favorite of all is When Love Takes Over.
I remember When Love Takes Over sweetly, because that's when I feel like I found myself in my 20s.
Mm.
Those were some good times.
Okay.
Good. Yes.
Great. Now it's mommy time.
Okay,
got it.
Okay, I have a question.
Okay.
You originally broke out with your plays and then films around your Madea character. What is your favorite Madea scene or line of dialogue across the entire franchise?
Oh. I every time she does something, it's just so stupid and so ridiculous. I just love when she gets to, like, somebody takes a parking spot and she lifts the car and flips it over.
Yes.
Or she goes and vindicates her niece by cutting up furniture.
Yes.
Just the things that I want to do in real life that I can't.
Yes.
You know, when you just want something up, but you
yes.
can't, you have to just, so I get to let it all out through her. So anytime she gets a release, I'm grateful.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
My question for you.
Mm-hmm.
Musically, on your bucket list, who do you want to work with?
Ooh, I will say.
I'm ready. I can sing.
No ID.
You don't have an ID?
No ID is the producer. Stop it.
Okay.
I won't have you look like that.
I'm joking.
No ID. I know you know.
I know.
So no ID. Raphael Sadiq.
Mm.
And Sade.
Sade. Ooh, that sounds good. Yeah.
Just a vibe.
Okay. What is the best date night you've been taken on?
I will probably have to say it was a beach day. It was myself, my husband, and my son. And we went to the beach and we just took pictures. We played in the ocean. We just had a really just sweet day. It was so simple.
That's awesome.
What are you most proud of in your growth as a filmmaker?
Just my ability to be able to collaborate and be open and be malleable. And you've taught me a lot of that. It's like, here, let's try this. Let's do this. Because I'm always so, here's what I'm doing. Let's go. If you ain't going, get your ass off the train.
That's literally what he does.
Yeah, but to have someone come and say, hey, TP. And you're so slick at it too. You know I was, you know. Hey, TP, let's talk about this. I'm like, what do you think about this? And by the time we got through all of your what do you think about, the budget was way over what it was supposed to be. I was like, but I look at her, she'd have that smile. I'm like, okay, she's happy. Let's just do it. Let's just do it.
Yep, okay, final question. You're one of the busiest creatives in this business. What does an ideal day off like look like, or like a self-care day? What does it look like for you?
It's absolutely doing nothing nothing. Nothing. Like I build remote control airplanes. That's mm-hmm. it. I want to sit there in my pajamas. I want to have glue and fiberglass and stuff all over me. I want to be dusty and dirty. Me and my son just building the airplanes. Just that is the perfect day.
That is dope.
And for me, your final question. Yes. At this stage in your career, would you want to lean more towards the acting or the music?
I still love my music.
Yeah.
But I'm finding a really beautiful rhythm in ideas and creative and thinking of different stories to tell.
I personally don't think you have to make a choice.
I don't have to make a choice.
You don't have to make a choice. The way you produce this movie with me, I clearly know that that is a total gift for you to do any way you want to do it.
Yeah.
And music is always going to be that love.
Yes.
And the two go hand in hand. It's all creative. It's all art. It's all about inspiring, lifting, and getting it out of you. So
absolutely.
You got it.
Absolutely. Thank you.
You got it. You got it.